Hey everybody and welcome to this video. My name is Yannis, I'm a musician and producer, and in this video I want to show you how you can create some jazzy floating ambient live set in Ableton Live that is actually going to generate all the musical content based on randomized parameters. It takes a little while to set it up, but once it's done, it's actually really fun. And to just directly give you some sound example, I'm going to show you a couple of excerpts from a video that I just released a couple of days ago, where I just used exactly those concepts that I'm going to show you and was sending them out of Ableton into my analog synthesizer. So in Ableton, you just need any type of sound generator, and I've picked Wavetable and created some very basic sound because I really like it, but you can use all those different instruments or also your analog synth that you connected to Ableton, really doesn't matter. You just need anything that can produce a sound. And as I mentioned, all musical content will be generated randomly, although we set some frame for what can happen. And later I'm also going to show you what kind of things you can assign to your MIDI controller so you can actually guide the music without ever thinking of the musical notes because they're going to fit all the time. And so in order to start, you just open your synth, whatever you want to use, and you insert some MIDI clip and just program a whole note like this, and it doesn't really matter which pitch, because we're going to randomize it anyway. And then we're going to add some arpeggiator that you find under MIDI effects. And now you see, if I play this clip, that we have this kind of rhythm. I always like 16th notes though. And so now we have this kind of rhythm with just this note that we programmed. But there's another nice MIDI effect in Ableton that is called random, and we're going to add it now as well. And this lets you randomize completely the notes that you're playing. And don't worry, we're also going to put it into some structure, but I just want to show you the kind of naked random effect first. So the chance is just the probability if there will be another note or not. At 50, it's just a 50% chance, and here you'll always get another note. And the choices is the amount of possible other notes. And the scale is the kind of step that all those kind of alternative notes take. So if the scale is at 1, it means that it's just a semitone. And so if I would play now the clip and deactivate random, you see it's just a semitone higher because the chance is 100%, so it will never be the original tone. But there's only one choice, and the scale is 1, so if I would increase the scale, see, those are 2 semitones, 3, 4, and so on. And if I increase the choices, it just jumps around a little more because there are more tones that are possible. And that's kind of the basic principle of this effect, and you can choose between add, that means it goes up. If I would here use sub, you would see that it goes down. And by just alternates between those both directions. So actually, for this very simple example, we're going to have 2 different notes. Or 3 if we mix in this again. And that's just how it works. And we're going to leave chance at 100, and scale 1 is actually something I enjoy. And we'll just increase the choices for our next step, which will be the scale. And this approach is kind of like some random electronic version of modal jazz, which became really famous by Miles Davis Kind of Blue record, which if you don't know it, I can really encourage you to listen to it because it's really a milestone in music, no matter what kind of genre you're interested in. And at this particular style, it was really about pointing out the color and character of a scale, especially those church modes. There are some scales called church modes that all have the same notes as the typical major scale, but played from different positions, which always brings up some new, very exciting tonal color. And this scale effect actually has some presets that gives you lots of scales already, and not only those church modes, also other ones that you can just add, and you don't have to worry about dealing with this matrix because it looks a little scary. And I'm going to pick Dorian because it's a mode that I really like. And just something for you to keep in mind, if you keep finding those things I use, like the scales or the chords that we'll have later, if you will find them interesting, I have a course on Skillshare with a link where you can do it for 2 weeks for free in the description, where I just speak about jazz harmony in some kind of coherent way so you can apply those things to your music easily. You don't always have to go too much in depth, although you can. And yeah, if you're interested in those sounds I mentioned but feel like, okay, they are new to you and you want to learn more about them, just keep it in mind. I'm also going to mention it 2 times more, I think, probably. We'll see. And so now we have this Dorian mode and this kind of matrix. You don't have to understand it, because if you pick the scale here, all you have to worry about is the root note, so the first note the scale starts with or actually is based on. But just to try explaining it in a few seconds, so this bottom line actually says which kind of note you press on your keyboard. So if you press a C, C sharp, D, D sharp, it's just kind of in an order. And this YX axis actually says which note you're going to hear. So if the same name matches both axes, so for example here you have C on the X axis and also on the Y axis, you also hear a C, but here you have a C sharp on the Y axis, on the X axis, so you press the C sharp on your keyboard, but still you will hear a C. So the notes are going to be synced to the scale, so you can just never play a wrong note, which is basically the system of this thing. And in the way it is programmed here, it means that it always looks for the closest note that is part of the scale if you're just playing a note that is not part of the scale. And since we have this random thing, there will be plenty of notes that are outside of the scale, but through synchronizing it through the scale effect, they will all actually be within the scale, which is really cool. And so now if I would press play, and let's have a few more choices, and you get all those notes of the Dorian scale. And also you can increase the size of the steps, so you will get a more jumpy type of movement. And here actually, sometimes if you pick a random note, it's maybe too high, so put it 1 octave down. And interesting. So sometimes it will leave notes out if they are too high for the register. But this way you get some nice kind of scale. You can also adjust the sound of the sound with the arpeggiator, although it's not that important. Also here, if you add some steps, it will go 1 octave higher occasionally. And of course now it sounds a little silly, but it's going to change. Actually, I'm still going to... You can see this way you can play around with the range and just pick the one that is the most interesting to you. And this way we're going to stay in C all the time, or you can just change it here, and you will see that all the time the color changes because it also synchronizes those random notes to a new scale, still Dorian, but from another, played from another note. And this is something we're actually going to randomize now by making a new track. It doesn't even matter if MIDI or audio, because we're just going to put some LFO onto it, and we have it under audio effects and modulators. Yes. Some really great tool, by the way, because you can have a lot of fun with it. And we're going to pick the random waveform, because this way we don't change between 1 and 0. Kind of, because then you, with those other things, you always have 2 things you change between. And here you also land at those in-between steps, which is pretty cool. And you can sync it to bars. So we could say, actually, it's let's take 2 bars. So every 2 bars, the root note is going to change. And we're going to map the LFO now to the root note of this scale. So now if we play it, every two bars we're going to change. And again. And don't worry, it's not going to sound like this forever. You heard the intro, just takes a while to get there. So just if it sounds annoying for a while, just try to ignore it. You have to go through this. As I said, it takes a little time to get there. And also those scales make way more sense if you add some bass, because a bass note gives this nice kind of feeling of relation in terms of tonality, because those scales, especially in this random order, can just sound a little random by themselves. And so we're going to actually duplicate this one. So this one is then called Dorian scale, and let's call this one Dorian bass and give it another color. And here we can actually get rid of the arpeggiator and also the random. Although there's something you could do with the random, but we're going to keep it simple for now. And then we're going to select only the bottom row of this matrix, because for now we want the bass to only play bass. So we pick again some random note, and then we assign this LFO also to this bass scale. And one more thing about the bass: at some point with this kind of two bar sync of the LFO, I had some problems with the bass, because sometimes it actually got triggered one bar too late. And what I did was dragging this MIDI note a little behind, because then it still sounds like it's on time, but somehow this made sure that it gets triggered properly. I don't know if it's just some issue that I had, but if you encounter this, just give it a try if you realize that your bass always changes one bar too late. Because now if we play both, now you can see that actually there's some more stable feeling, because this bass gives the scale more kind of definition, and now you can more feel the tension of this Dorian scale. And you can do the same with chords, because now I'm going to duplicate the bass track and call this Dorian chords. And we want to have the same effect that we have with a bass, that we only want one note, which is the root note, to be generated all the time. And so we can actually already map it also to the LFO. But then we want it to create chords, and there's also a MIDI effect called chord, which is great. And this Dorian chord usually really sounds good with a particular voicing. Again, something I really speak about in this Skillshare course, if you're interested. And here it's the thing that with the chord in Dorian, you always start on the third. So let's say, actually you don't need to relate it to a note. So we have a third, then we have the fifth. It's a minor third, of course. Then we have the seventh. And then we actually have the ninth, and this should already be enough for some proper chord. Although you could think of adding the 11th and 13th. Again, those things I could elaborate on, but yeah, I speak about all of this in this course. And you can also just copy it right now and be happy with the sound. And also here probably you get those, oh, major, seventh, major, yeah. I'm sure there are some cool presets, but I like to create them based on what I know, because some voicings can sound really boring, and this way it usually always sounds cool. And now actually I'm gonna have to change this to a polyphonic sound. Oh yes, nice. Maybe make this a little more pad. Beautiful. decent mode in on Wavetable. It's amazing. But now you can see, now it sounds actually properly like some very nice color. It is really enjoyable to listen to. In this way, you have your kind of first scene or setting and your first kind of scale. But what is also really great is if at some point you also change to another scale, because now you stay in Dorian, and this would be totally fine to play around with for a while, especially with those MIDI mappings I'm going to show you in the end. But yeah, let's add another scale. And what we do now is actually to duplicate all of those tracks. And now we're going to use Mixolydian, because it's one I also really like. So we call this Mixolydian scale, and we drag this to the next row, and you'll see why just in a second. So this is going to be the Mixolydian bass. And the Mixolydian chord. And actually here we call this the LFO channel, because now we create some other LFO, because you can see here the LFO only has 8 mappings. That means with what I'm going to show you now, you quickly run out of mappings. So I'm just going to add a new one, and actually this one we call, this is now the Dorian LFO, and now we are going to add the Mixolydian LFO. And again, 2 bars, random wave, and don't forget to drag those to the next line. And now, with the Mixolydian scale, we just again go to our scale effect, and this time we just choose Mixolydian, and erase the Dorian, and we do the same for the bass. Dorian has to go and Mixolydian comes in. And for the chords, we actually can leave this, because we anyway only need this for the root note. Oh, and actually for the bass as well. So this was actually useless to delete it here, but never mind. And here we now have to change the chord. So because we have a dominant 7th chord in Mixolydian, means we need some major 3rd. And again, the 5th. Actually, I'm not even convinced of the 5th. We can leave it out and instead take a 13. That always sounds really nice with those types of sounds. And now all we need to do is map the Mixolydian LFO to all those 3 instances. And yeah, you just have to focus a little to not get to the wrong mode, because then you mess this whole system up. And let's actually listen now to the Mixolydian thing. Of course, that was my mistake, because I entered the Mixolydian mode into the bass, so now it's just all over the place. So you have to make sure that the bass only has those lowest notes. Yes, that's the sound. And now you can change between those 2. And so you have some other kind of harmonic tension that sometimes can appear. And this principle you can just repeat multiple times, because you can just check some other scales. Also, somehow, if you never heard of scales, it's also kind of a cool thing to just pick a random one. Those Messiaen modes are really interesting, but it's also something that can sound a little pretentious if you use it in the wrong moment. But to just mess around with it, why not? And so you always duplicate the track you have and just replace the scale for the scale voice because the bass can actually stay the same because it's only there for the root note and the scale effect. And for the chords, you just have to think of what kind of chord sound you want to have. So you have to think of major third, what kind of seventh, maybe a 13 or some 9. Again, I'm sorry if those things are sound a little cryptical to you, but again, this I just don't want to put everything into one video, and this course just explains this all on Skillshare. You can find the link in the description. And I'm not going to make more copies now because you get the basic principle and just can now keep adding them. The thing I want to show you is how you can now use follow actions in order to also randomize the changes between those two sections. Because if you double click here on the right side at this kind of launch button, you get this little menu where you can click on follow action. And here you can go to any, which means after this kind of scene gets triggered, it will, after a time that you pick here, and I'm going to pick actually two, so for two bars it will stay in this clip, but then after those two bars, any other clip, and I mean now there are only two, but it's enough for demonstration purposes, will be triggered. And so you can see if I now do this. Here it automatically goes here, and of course if it's only two different choices, sometimes it's also going to select the same one again, but if you do the same for here, any as a setting and two bars, it's going to keep playing and changing forever. And so on. And that's kind of the musical foundation of what's happening here. And I think if you have like four different types of scales, it's already a good amount. What I would really encourage you to try is Lydian, because it's super beautiful. And also maybe just some normal minor mode, or some Phrygian can be really great as well. So just try it, and also feel kind of disrespectful to any kind of music theory sometimes. Just try some things, because the only thing that matters is that you connect to the sound, and not that somebody once said that some particular mode sounds good or not. And now for the MIDI mappings, I just give you a few examples of what is really fun and what I also did in my video, so you can kind of relate to it. So I always assign one knob to the tempo, which seems a little odd, but this is super great because this way you're like a conductor with some orchestra that can just change the tempo and sometimes make it super slow, because you don't want the same sound all the time. And if you make it really slow, you just make it sound completely different, and it stays within the structure for a way longer time. And then I also usually assign one controller to the arpeggiator rate, and I do it for all different scales that I have. So both, in this case, the Dorian scale and the Mixolydian scale, have one knob of the controller assigned to the arpeggiator, and it's the same knob. So if I change it for one of those, it's going to be changed for the other one as well. And this way, you can also really change the tempo. Oh, I meant the wrong one, wait. So let's say we do it here. Completely different. Oh, it was actually this one. Sorry, I was a little confused. But yeah, you could see that here. Ah, because it's on the follow actions. Ah. See, this is the thing, you have to stay focused all the time, because otherwise you sometimes are confused because you forgot about something. But now you could see that here you can also perfectly change the sound of the whole thing. And then it depends on how you use it. If you use some software synth, definitely assign something to the cutoff frequency, so you can make the sound more open and also more dark, because that's really important, because with my synthesizer I did it of course on the device. And also what is really nice to put a scent to a reverb, because this way you can sometimes create this kind of cloud of sound that I'm also going to do, but that I'm also doing there, although it's with my Eventide pedal, which can also perfectly alter the whole character. And of course the chance to mute things, super important, because you don't want to have everything all the time. You just want to create different kinds of colors, so also have a button for mute, but most of the MIDI controllers actually have this already pre-routed. And one last thing I can really encourage you to map to a MIDI controller is the choices button of the random, because if you... Let's actually deactivate the follow actions for this example, because let's just play this second one. This is now MIDI slow. Ah. So for example, you can really narrow down the notes and also maybe assign one to the scale. You can really get different types of motifs and actually more motive type sounds. And eventually change the arpeggiator to random, so it's less structured if you operate with kind of smaller sections. If you go here really high, you get kind of interruptions in the rhythm, which is really cool. And so this way you can also alter the sound without ever thinking about harmony while you actually perform. And you could also randomize those by using another LFO that would actually alter the choices in the scale, but this can sound extremely... It can sound quite funky to be... Actually, I'm gonna do it once. So if you add some LFO here... Oh, yeah. And this way in time we can maybe even take a sine wave. Doesn't really matter. To choices and make it really slow. Maybe also you can narrow down here the section that it changes, so it doesn't have that drastic impact on the sound. And also for the scale. And also this we'll narrow down a little, maybe like this. And you get some kind of variation, although the scale should stay on the lower part in my opinion. So there's always, I always see it as either you control something with the MIDI controller or you do the LFO random thing. And for this thing, it also works really, really nicely. You could also do it for the arpeggiator if you really want some chaos. So for example, if you alter the rate, you see what can happen. In this section, you're a little more chill. But this way you can also alter the rhythm a little, which is really fun. And again, you could also map those things to a MIDI controller, but yeah, you see, the possibilities are endless, and I also don't want to overburden you with things. This is supposed to give you some kind of ideas of what you can actually do with, or how you can actually set up randomized structures that you can use for a live set and just keep making ambient music for hours through, theoretically, with a combination of different tempos, pitches, scales, and rhythms. And you can all, yeah, you can do all of this. And this is kind of, yeah, I think this is enough for today to give you to work with. Also, I know with this, those things, it's very difficult to stay structured because you always stumble upon something and think, I should mention this and I forgot this. So if anything wasn't so clear or you have any questions, just be invited to ask them in the comments, because I'm also always going to reply to them. And I really know that it's impossible to always get everything immediately. And that's already it for today. I mean, already, it was quite some content. And just, yeah, remember to just drop me any questions if I was not clear somewhere. Otherwise, thanks a lot for watching. I really hope you enjoyed this video. And if that's the case, be warmly invited to subscribe to my channel. I'm always super happy about any new subscriber. And I'm also sure if you like this video that you can find some other content on my channel that is also interesting to you, because there are quite some videos about creative music production at home and some synthesizer performances. Also, once more, the reminder that if you like those kind of sounds and jazzy chords and scales, etc., there's this link to my Skillshare course in the description that gives you a 14-day free trial, which is quite some time to learn those basics already, I think. And apart from that, I just wish you inspiration with whatever it is that you create, that you stay healthy, and I'd be super happy to see you soon again at my channel. Bye!